We have seen in the past that, for example, bad harvests can lead to political instability, especially in fragile countries. There is a massive security issue here. The melting of the ice cap will open up new economic opportunities. The northern route will become ice-free. It could lead to all kinds of competition for scarce resources because there's lots of interesting stuff under the ice which will become available. We already see that the Arctic is an area where there's more military activity than there used to be. Climate change will have many different implications for the military, starting with the maritime dimension. If the sea level rises, your coastal installations will be flooded more and more frequently. Take the heat in the Middle East, which is going up. If you have 50 degrees or more, your military gear will not be able to shield you from that heat. If you have more sandstorms in certain areas, for example, you will not be able to do reconnaissance flights anymore. If you have roads that go along coastal areas, they will be flooded, therefore be unusable most of the time. So we have already many cases where climate change is changing the way we need to plan and execute military operations. And then, of course, there's the other question, if climate change does lead to humanitarian disasters, what role will the military play and what role will NATO play in the future? First of all, we have to measure how much greenhouse gas does our military emit. That is not an easy thing, but we're working on that right now. We're working on a methodology to measure greenhouse gas emissions in the military. And then you will have to think about to set goals for reduction of greenhouse gas emissions. But you also need to look at new technologies. What technologies are available that give you what we call the win-win, lower environmental footprint, but full combat capability, because we cannot compromise on that. So there are very interesting experiments being done in many allied nations on biofuels, for example, and many other things. And it's important to use NATO as a framework to exchange best practices among allies and hopefully among partners as well, so that we get a higher IQ when it comes to understanding how to reduce greenhouse gas emissions in the military.